What's up, everybody? Happy Wednesday. Oh, I see you guys are already in the chat. What's up? All right. We're gonna do something a little different. We're gonna do some Tank Girl. Figure this will be fun. Playing around some fun stuff. Oh, heck yeah, Tank Girl. And I don't have a very high resolution image here, but that's okay. We'll go through and hopefully bust out some flats real quick. I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do today, but I feel like the flats are just dragging on and I'm not getting anything. I do have a smaller, shorter piece that I can do. I just didn't think it would last the whole time. So Tim, was that a rocksmith score? Is that what you sent to me? Lori Petty was perfect for Tank Girl. I have no idea what that is. Musician? Never heard of it. What's musician all about? What's their shtick? Oh, nice. Nice. It's got to be a lot easier to see on the fly. Or interpret on the fly, rather. Yeah, totally. I could see that. I could see that. Right. Yeah, that's cool. You have to show me it next time I'm over, man. I've been meaning to do some painting out in the garage studio, but it's been getting cold and I haven't cleaned up in there, and I have a space heater, but I haven't tested how well that kicks out heat. Oh, nice. That's super cool. They do it all, huh? So it's subscription based? You know, with all of the remakes and revisions and remasters that have been happening in the movie world, I'm kind of surprised there hasn't been a Tank Girl. I mean, even something like, low budget independent. Tank Girl's always maintained quite a bit of love. Nice. My niece is watching. They're at a basketball game. They can't hear anything. Oh, didn't mean to zoom in that far. All right. Cruising along, trying to bust out these flats. The other picture that I had that I was working on was by Max Dunbar, who's the same guy that did that Conan sketch that I did on the last live stream. And that guy has some fantastic work. He's gone on to actually work with Wizards of the Coast on like a whole bunch of D&D related stuff. It's really fantastic. But the other one that I was working on flatting is what kind of made me think of Tank Girl, because it almost has this like Mad Max kind of vibe to it. There's a guy and a girl hanging out of a car with a rocket launcher and a, I think, a shotgun or something like that. But the image itself isn't very detailed, which is why I didn't do it tonight, just because I figured it'd only take me, an hour, hour and a half to bust out. So someone at work had asked me if I'd ever done any like challenges as far as art goes. And I had told her about Novrender and how I did that last year. I just couldn't, don't have the time and energy and resources to do Novrender again and do it right. There's other like YouTubers out there and stuff that do a lot of like drawing challenge or color challenges and stuff like that, but I've never done any. But if that's something you guys think you might find interesting, definitely let me know. If you have any, if you've seen any challenges that you think might be cool, send them my way. Let me know about it. And that's something I can either do during a live stream, or I can even just do an independent video and release that if you think it might be interesting to see what I can do on some of these challenge videos. Do an entire color or do an entire picture and only this color or only these couple colors or in this particular style or whatever the case might be. It might be fun to do some stuff like that. Mix it up a little bit. Really? There's a random power cord intertwined with her hair. Why not? You're absolutely right, Lincoln. She's the antithesis of, punk rock feminist. Mixed with so much, I don't give a damn. I don't know if anyone watched Orange is the New Black, but Lori Petty was actually in Orange is the New Black. And I just always see, and probably always will see her as Tank Girl. I just can't get her out of my head as Tank Girl. Yeah, I never watched it. That's cool. What kind of role did she have in that? Oh, yeah, dude. I totally forgot about Point Break. Such a ridiculous movie. And awesome. Oh, fair enough. Either of you ever watched the remake they did? The Point Break it just a handful of years ago? Yeah, they totally did. Totally did. I don't remember who was in it or any of that. But it was definitely a thing. I have been leaking, thank you. So much detail in this thing. To mess around with the stripes and see what looks best. Maybe like a red and white, or black and white, or red and black. Tinkerbell's another one of those characters that, color-wise, you just have all the freedom and flexibility in the world. Just because she's just a hodgepodge of whatever's feeling right at the moment for her. So the clothing is always just off the wall. All right, we got the roller skate. Okay. All right, what color shoelaces should we go for here? Maybe like some clashy green ones. Think that's what we'll go with this. Why not? Yeah, what's good about the Tank Girl piece is you don't have to be good at picking colors per se. I imagine that she found these roller skates that were probably some little girl's at some point and decked them out with whatever shoelaces she happened to find lying around and, stuff like that. The color doesn't matter all that much. Yes, I understand. Will say it's looking really fun. It really, really is. A lot going on. Kind of all over the place. It's great. I think that since there's a yellow smiley pin, we need to change the color of her shirt. Yeah, I'm kind of flatting and color picking all kind of at the same time. Just kind of jumping around. I think given that she has a target on her boob that's in red, maybe we change the color of what's on her arm. Hey, April. That's funny. It's true. Tank Girl is pretty awesome. Oh. Yeah, I guess there's a little bit of a booty hanging out. That's not how that's supposed to work. Can we try that again, please? There we go. There we go, that makes more sense. I was completely staring at it going, how is that strap just floating there? right, later, man. Have a good one. Yeah, me too. Fingerless gloves. Okey doke. What time is it? 8:35. Wow. Sometimes you just kind of get in the zone and things just start going by real quick. Ooh, still so much going on. I'm not 100% at what I'm looking at. In that area. Is it folded up pants? Is it some sort of loose belt? I don't know. Is this a random rubber just floating in midair? Because it looks like it. I have no idea what's happening. Right. Let's keep moving on. That's what I thought, but it's just kind of floating there. Where are we at? We have a bunch of tattoos. Yeah, the tattoos are going to be interesting. The tattoos are going to be interesting. We have some details up here I still need to hit. Okay. Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm still just doing the flats. I mean, there's so much going on, so much cool detail that, I mean, even with just flats, it's looking pretty awesome already. It's this one's there's just so many visual elements just aside from the color that you just can explore it forever and just find new cool things about it. But I'm gonna take quick five minutes here. Be right back, and we'll keep plugging away on Tank Girl. Be right back. Thank you. Okay, I'm back. All right. Let's keep plugging away. Thank you. Thanks for sticking around. Yeesh. All right. I need to take a second to take a step back and look and see what the heck I have going on. Think we're down to the tattoos before we can actually do some rendering on this. Nope, don't like that. The only thing I think of with the 23 is that it is an homage to Michael Jordan. So it only makes sense that it's red. I mean, it could have some significance in the Tank Girl lore, but I have no idea. Aside from the movie, I've only read a couple of random issues that didn't have anything to do with each other. And that's actually regrettable. Maybe I'll try and dig some up. I like stuff that's like Tank Girl, like Transmetropolitans was very much like that. Felt like, anyhow. That's kind of fun. Not sure if that's too much, but it's kind of fun and I like it. Well, gang, this one might be a two-parter, just so I can get some rendering in. I mean, it looks awesome as in flats. It really does. I really like it, but I really want to see it rendered. There's just so much going on. I will say it's the first time in a long time that I just straight up enjoyed the flatting process, just because there's so much. Like fun, colorful stuff. But there's a lot to render that I'm just simply not going to get to in the next 20 minutes. So yeah. Let's go ahead and call this one good for now, and then I'll go ahead and move on to this other one that I've been working on. If I can find it, I have so much. So much. Ah, there it is. So this is another one that I've been working on. Just slowly, and I didn't think this one here would take up enough time, so I didn't do this one, but I've been slowly plucking away at this one. This one got me thinking of Tank Girl, just because the style and the bazookas and shotgun. This is a fun one to just kind of wind down to. So yeah, come hang out next week. We'll finish up that Tank Girl. I was really enjoying the process on that. Want to make sure I'm giving it proper attention. I don't want to rush that one, 'cause I like it. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, sorry about that, Lakin. For sure, for sure. I'm sure I'll post it online along with the time lapse and stuff. I've been slacking on my time lapses, by the way. I haven't done a time lapse in a while. I still have stuff from last month. That's bad. I should be better about that. Aren't most antennas on the passenger side? Yeah, thank you. I thought as much. Right. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Yeah, it's hard to say. I have no idea. Yeah, other than this being art by Max Dunbar, I really don't know anything about it. It was called Happy New Year, because I think he posted it like on New Year's one year. That would make sense because someone in the comments of this piece said something about Pantera, badass. Yeah, I thought about that as well. I have no idea what this guy is wearing. Yeah, that makes sense. Good to know. If that's what the car looked like, it looks kind of cool. I'll have to Google it. Am not familiar with the vehicle. Right on. Yeah, California has all sorts of weird, freaky laws. All right, guys. Well, we're gonna go ahead and call it. It's 9:30. Did I pick the green? As in of this vehicle? Yeah. I just randomly threw a color on there and I was like, you know, I kind of like it. Why? Green's unlucky for vehicles. Or okay, fair enough. Fair enough. All right, guys. Well, I'm gonna call it here. Thanks for hanging out. We'll see you next Wednesday. Again, if there's anything you want to see me do as far as any sort of arts or pieces or styles or challenges or anything like that, let me know. Get at me and, you know, we'll see if we can do something. Take care.